Authors Tell All, a podcast by Shy Soul. She's bringing you author interviews, book discussions, and more. Stay tuned.
Hello everyone, we are live with Hejaz SeeCash. He will be talking about his music and more, so let's get into this. Okay,
what's up?
Okay, hi, how you doing?
Finding yourself, sister?
I'm doing well. This is about to be different, a very different interview, because you know I interview authors and whatnot, and we talk about books. So this is going to be a different light on the podcast tonight. Mm-hmm. Okay, so let's just get started. Okay, first of all, I want to talk about, where did you grow up?
I grew up in Crown Heights, Brooklyn.
Okay, and how was that? What was that like?
Oh, man. Crown Heights, it was rough. I grew up in a real grimy era. I'm talking about, like, when you get your bamboo earring snatched, getting stuck up. You name it. Crack dealers, Jamaicans wearing travel fox, getting beat up. Man, the list goes on.
Wow.
I'm in the golden era.
Wow, that's crazy. That's something. Okay, and when did you start getting into music?
I can say, like, I took an interest of rap and rap at 11 years old.
Wow,
you know, it just came to me in a vision, man. I just started writing, you know, and I, of course, I had my inspirations, like, Run DMC, you know, Kool Moe Dee, people like that, but it just took off.
Wow, that's, now see, that's what I like when artists start off young. You know, and then they get inspiration from very dope artists. And, you know, they want to make it just like they did. So, who is your favorite artist, your favorite hip-hop artist, now and back then?
I would have to say LL Cool J. Now?
Mainstream or underground?
It's hard to say, man. I would honestly and truthfully, it's so many of them, man. It's hard to pick. It's hard to choose, man. Like, I'm real weird when it comes to music, man. I guess I probably would go with Fuji Rap.
Mm-hmm.
He's ill. I guess I'd go with a little bit of Drake. I show Drake love. Definitely.
Hmm.
I like the wordplay. You know, he slept on as an MC, but I give him recognition. He deserves the prop.
Wow. Okay. Now, see, if...
He's clever with the pen. He's clever.
Okay. Now, if for somebody, if this was reversed, and if you was to ask me that, I would be like, okay. Now, I am a 90s baby. Okay, I'm young, but I love me some music, okay? So, if you was to ask me who is my favorite artist back then, I would have to go with Tupac. Okay, he was very lyrical.
Tupac.
Yeah, he was very lyrical, and he has things to say, and he spoke his mind. Now, times have changed with the hip-hop and the music and everything, so for me to say my favorite hip-hop artist now, I know it's going to be a lot of people on my feed going to be like, really? I'm gonna be like, yeah, my favorite. And she's female. And she's Nicki Minaj. I love her.
Nicki Minaj is a beast. She's a beast.
Thank you. I love her wordplay and how she's different. And, you know, they say that, oh, she copied off of Lil' Kim. Okay, but how many other artists have inspired off of other artists and, you know, they became popular? Okay, that's what happens. That's what the industry does. But she is my favorite. She's been my favorite for a long time, since I was a teenager. Okay, maybe I wasn't supposed to be listening to her music when I was a little bit younger, but I love her regardless. And she
put in that work.
Yeah.
Way back.
Yeah, and she does have her inspirational ways too. You know, when she's on Instagram and when it's around graduation time, she's gonna be like, y'all post y'all graduation pictures, I'm sharing it, because that's what she preaches on her shows and stuff. Okay, she twerks, she does all that, but she's still a good rapper, and she writes her own raps. So that's what I love about her.
Definitely. Did you see the interview just recently? Yeah. With her, I think Funk Flex?
Of course I did. I was on that when I got the notification. I had my notifications turned on for her.
great interview, man.
And it was, and people didn't like that she's finally, you know, speaking up and saying what she has to say, and people don't like that. Okay, they're rooting for Cardi B now. Okay, don't get me wrong, I like Cardi B. You know, she has some good songs. She has some good songs that I listen to. I'm not gonna knock her at all, but I wouldn't dare compare the two, because they're two black queens, okay? No matter whatever you put it, they're both doing great. So why can't we root for both of them? Why do we have to choose one? I'm not gonna choose. Nobody's gonna.
Okay, I was thinking of Cardi for a second, man, but she makes some good music.
Yeah, she definitely has some good music. And they're talking about some, she's gonna take Nicki's spot and all this. I'm like, they're both roaring in the industry, so I don't see that coming. They're both making good money, so why not just root for both of them and just leave that alone? So you writing your own music, how do you feel when artists, they get ghostwriters and stuff? How do you feel about that?
Dudes not only have ghostwriters, they got ghostwriters.
Yep.
I mean, rap is so WWE now, man. It's like wrestling, man. It's so fake, man. Like, I mean, it's entertainment. It's all entertainment, man. I mean, it takes away from the artist, man. Because, like, just say for instance, right, you got your favorite rapper to get.
Mm-hmm.
He kicking some real gully gangsta shit. And you find out somebody else wrote it. It's like, it takes away from the artist. But, you know, it's a business, you know? Like, I mean, it is what it is. Some people don't like it, man. I mean, for me, I'm like, if I'm feeling you, I'm feeling you, man. I'll go with the flow, man. It is what it is, man. I ain't hating, man. Get paper. That's all I got to say.
Which is very true. Very, very true. So, what are you currently working on right now?
Well, I've been blessed to work. I'm working on a Legal Hustle Volume 2 album with Cormega. I got a few features on it, which is dope. Like, incredible, man. Cormega's he's an underground legend. He was signed to Def Jam early in his career. I think he has a firm, Nas, and Foxy Brown, and AZ. That album should be dropping like very soon. It's going to be ridiculous, man. Like, it's going to be crazy, man. It's going to be bananas. Trust me, man. And I'm doing a movie thing, of course, you know, working on a few movies.
Oh, I'm going to ask you about that.
Yeah.
Okay, so you was on my favorite show on Netflix, Luke Cage. You was an extra. Tell me about that.
Oh, yeah. I was definitely an extra on that, man. Like, that was dope. Like, when I got on that show, I didn't even know who Luke Cage was. I knew about Luke Cage. Like, I knew Luke Cage was, like, the comic book hero.
Mm-hmm.
But I didn't know it was Luke Cage. You know, so I did the extra work. It was background. It was a background feature. So I did that. and I forgotten about it. And just recently, you know, I was on the elliptical working out, and somebody had told me about the show, and I'm like, I didn't even watch it. I said, wait a minute, that's me. Oh, shit, that's me. And I was like, hype. I was like, wow. That's what's up. And the show is so dope. It is hilarious, too, man.
I love it.
The joke will have you rolling, man. You just got to catch it, man. Like, I actually, you know, I met the director, too. I didn't even know he was the director at the time. I mean, it's like he just came on the thing real smooth and casual. And I'm like, yo, what up, man? He's like, introduce himself to me. Then, like, later on in a year, I see his picture on Instagram. I was like, wait a minute, so, you know, that was definitely a blessing right there. Definitely a blessing.
Yes. And I see, me as an author, if I was to meet one of my favorite authors, I would be like, wait a minute. Oh, why didn't have my business card? Why didn't have my book on me? Be like, please, you know? So, that's something. That's awesome, actually. That really is.
You inspired me so much, man. Like, let me tell you. After that, I was like, yo, I really need to take this craft seriously. So I went auditioned for this agency called Seven Plaza Talent in Pennsylvania, and they signed me. I'm telling you, it was on. Straight up.
Wow. That's what's up. Okay, so you recently just finished doing a New Balance commercial? Really?
Mm-hmm.
Tell me about that too. This is interesting.
You know, when I was on set doing that, I was making fun of everybody. I was like, I'm a Central Park jogger from way back in the days, you know. It was dope, man. It was really hot out there. They gave the New Balance apparel, threw that on. I was jogging. It was like, I think it's coming out in September. I think it's they're promoting the Olympics. But it was like I was blown away just doing that right there. It was like a dream come true. And I love New Balance. I love New Balance. I just couldn't pick the shirt that I wanted. You know, I was like, I want a sailor. Now you're gonna wear that right there. I was like, okay, put it on. And it was number love. Got paid very well too, very handsomely. So, you know, I walked up the set with a Kool-Aid smile. Definitely.
Okay, so let's get more back into your acting. So, you just finished a new show on CBS. What is the show called?
It's called Bull Series. Now, that show right there is just like Law and Order. Like, I mean, like, I used to see like little billboards, but I kind of slept on the show. Then, you know, I got the call to go in. I can't really give you, like, if I tell you what it's about, I can honestly get fired. Like I can get pre-fired. I can get banned. Period. But I can tell you this much. The episode that I'm on, it is dope. Superb. You're gonna love it. I can't even tell you what I played on it, man. Oh.
It's totally fine.
You never know who's listening.
It's totally fine, but that's something because, of course, you know, one day I would like to write a script and produce something that of one of my books that I've written, and you know, to get
book me.
I was just about to say, and book my own cast and contact you for a character. That's something I've always had the passion for, and can't wait to venture in soon, you know, and to have my own production and to be able to direct and write and control the whole scene. You know, we really don't have that many black women, black men doing that, and we need more of that.
Mm-mm. I just love being on set, man. It's such an adrenaline rush. It's a whole different atmosphere to being in the studio, to being an MC rapper. It's totally different.
So, what's your day-to-day plan? Like, is it music first, work first? What do you do on a daily-day basis?
Sure. When I wake up in the morning, I take a nice, I do a little 5K. I go sit down in my man cave. Might write some, you know, write some rhymes, write some, you know, put down my thoughts. Get on the internet, you know, go on Instagram. You know, start networking the net. Pretty much that's it, man. Like, but I'm always in that. Like, I'm always in that mood. I'm always hungry. I'll wake up hungry.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay, so what do you mean by when you say some rappers are just lazy with the pen?
I mean, like, if you hear a lot of these guys, man, I'm like, yo, man, you could have been better than that, man. Like, they'll say such simplistic rhymes. And I mean, like, you can... They feel that. They got it so good that, you know, if I got a nice new beat, whatever, I don't gotta, you know, use any metaphors or any punchlines. I can say A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, O, P. That's it, bam. That's it. I mean, give me something. Let me walk away with something. Like I crave for that, man. I love dope lines.
Mm-hmm.
I love it. I need something that I can just that I can travel with, man. Like, give me these guys, man. Some of them, man, they suck. And then to add insult to injury, they be like, "Yo, go out there and support my music. Support me." I'm like, "Yo, are you serious, man? Like, come on now, man." So me, I care about the fan. Like, when I sit back and I write a rap, it's like, take for instance, right? If you work in a bakery, right, you're in a business, right, you work in a bakery, you gotta make sure your cake tastes delicious. You just can't put cakes out there and then, like, all right, eat that. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Like, you gotta make sure your product is decent, it's delicious. So me, when I sit down and I write rhymes, y'all making sure my stuff is dope. Everything is dope. I take it seriously. I am a lyricist.
That's what I believe a artist should be too, because it's like a flow that you need to have. Okay, you need to have just those punchlines and just have me like, I'm rocking with this, you know? And it's like with poetry, you know, it has that flow and it just has those punchlines and then it sticks with you. So, with that question, I want to lead into how do you feel about the so-called mumble rappers of this new age rapping?
Okay, some of them can actually rap. They got something while others, they just corny as hell. I mean, they whack. Man, like, I mean, like, come on. But some of them are good. Some I listen. Like, I listen to the words simply, what they put together. But some just suck. Like, come on, dude. Like, you know you can do better than that, man. Like, where you coming from with that, man? Like, come on, man. Like, you know what? I pull those guys, cookie-cutter rappers.
Mm-hmm.
They just, you know, you got a cookie-cutter and all the shapes on the same size. Cookie-cutter rappers, man. They just, not all of them. Like, I'm not a hater. Like, I'm not a hater. I just like creativity.
Mm-hmm.
That's it. Bring it. That's why I give everybody a chance. Like, dudes that be sending me their music, I listen to it. I want to hear it. Like, kids just recently, I met old man in the event, in Boston some time ago. And shy Asian kid, man. He DM'd me. And he said, yo, Jazz, could you, he did some EPMD stuff. He said, could you please listen to my demo?
Mm-hmm.
So I said, okay, kid. So I heard him. Wow. This kid right here, he's better than a lot of other people that's on. And I could see that he was really putting emphasis to what he was saying. He was clever with his lines. I was like, wow. how, man? So, you know, I mean, these mumble dudes, man, like, allow me to step it up, man. I mean, like, show your fans some love, man. You know, I mean, give it up, man. Fact.
Right. That's how I feel. Now, see, me, I'm just the type where if I feel like I can't just mellow out to this, or if I can't dance to this, or if I can't even understand nothing you saying, I don't want to listen to it. I don't even want to have it in my phone, period. Like, delete it from my history. Like, how did you get signed? Because I'm that type of loyal, like, listening to hip-hop, pop, all that stuff. Okay, I expect a new artist to bring it. Like, if they're on a show and they're trying to win, I expect you to bring it just with that same energy. Don't bring no crap rap and expect it to sell. And then, obviously, it will sell because we have those, the new generation, who think, oh, this is rap. Sort of say, maybe. But I don't like it. I'm just telling like how it is. I don't like it. Yeah, there's no way I'm going to just
be
like...
Saying, like, one of my lines, I said, most rappers are born, they're not made. And that's facts.
Yeah, it's... I just can't deal with that. And if I want to rap along to a song and I don't even know what you're saying, and then I have to look up your lyrics to know what you're saying. I mean, okay, don't get me wrong, your beat might be hot, okay, just the beat, but then I can't understand what you're saying. It just it don't work out that way. So when was the point where you knew you was gonna go somewhere with either your music or your acting?
Interesting question. I mean, with the rap, okay, I gotta take it way back, right? My first gig, I used to go to like this, I used to go to camp, right?
Mm-hmm.
Go to camp in Crown Heights, Brooklyn, right? And it used to be this lady named, I think her name was Sherry E. Kemp. R.I.P. Mm-hmm. You know, she's dead right now, right?
Mm-hmm.
I used to always be rapping around her, rapping, you know, matching words, whatever. And she said, you know what? I got a friend that, she works for Channel 54. Her name is Nefertari Henderson, right?
Mm-hmm.
I want to bring you up there, and I want you to rap to her. And I was like, as a matter of fact, I want you to write a song about African history, right?
Mm-hmm.
And send it to me, and I'll send it to her, right? I forget how I did that. Oh, yeah, I did a demo with my brother, his name is DJ Larry Action. I did a demo, gave it to her. She gave it to Nefertari Henderson, and she loved it, man. I think it was called Get Involved. Like, you familiar with James Brown?
Yes.
you know James Brown, he got a song for, it's like, get involved. Maybe I'll make a long story short. Nefertari Henderson was blown away by the song, man. And I was like, I'm a star. I'm going to be on TV. Wow. So, how old I was? I had to be about maybe 13 or 14. Nice. So, what happened was, you know, she invited us to the station, but she said, I want you to write one more African song, right, about African history. So I wrote a song about Frederick Douglass. I never forget. And I never forget the day, you remember back, I don't know, like, you were 90 days, remember back in the day, people would get shot for Shirley Hope?
Yeah, my dad told me all that type of stuff. You know,
I just got a Shirley, right? And I thought I was the man. Just got a Shirley. And my brother was like, yo, not gonna ride the train with you. One of my, I have a brother named, he was a little, you know, he's a little Larry, a little paranoid. You know, you got one brother, he's like, he's soft, but not that soft. But mm-hmm. he's like, kind of soft.
Mm-hmm.
He's like, I'm not riding with you on a train with that Sherlin on. I said, yo, it's gonna be okay. We're gonna go to Channel 54. I'm gonna blow this joint out. Yo, and we're gonna get rich. Yo, I had the little Marco Mesh shades on and my Sherlin. I was shining. So I finally convinced him to go up there. And we did the thing. I messed up a lot. It was a terrible day, man. I was just so nervous. And then finally, I got it right. And that's what Tari Henderson was like, you know what? You remind me of somebody. I said, who? He said, you remind me of MC Hammer. I was like, what? MC Hammer? She said, no. Not his rap. She said, your hairstyle. You know, just the,
mm-hmm.
you know, I was like, okay. So, I was like, yo, I'm gonna blow, I'm gonna become something. So a few weeks later, Nefertari Henderson got me a script. It was for this cartoon series. I can't remember the name because I'm going back in the history. And they were trying to find somebody to invest in. And I think at the time, I don't know, maybe Wesley Snipes name might have popped up with somebody else, but they couldn't get an investor. And I was like, yo, I'm gonna blow, this is it for me, but it just never worked out. Mm-hmm. And you know, to me, I was like, yo, you know, I gotta keep it moving, but I got to dive in, man, and if I keep doing it, I know I'm gonna blow. So, you know, I was going to, you know, get to little treat battles and all that, you know, battling people, crying, you know, taking on people's heads and stuff like that. And I just knew that eventually, one of these days, you know, I was going to get put on. But it just never happened. I had this vision, like, you know, you can feel it. Sometimes you can feel it. And mm-hmm. I felt it deep in my heart. I said, one day I'm going to get put on. I'm going to blow. Something's going to happen. And eventually, you know, I ran to a few people. You know, I got with my man Mega years down the line. Mega, one of my closest friends, called Mega, he put me on, took me out to Queen Bridge. And yo, that brother right there, I can honestly say that brother right there, he put me on, because if it wasn't for him, there wouldn't be no Throwback Home at all. So salute to Core Mega, straight up. Yeah, man. I you know, I was doing like little shows every now and then. My first gig, I did it. I rapped in South Carolina. Oh my God, I destroyed the mic. I killed it, man. I had the country women going crazy. It was crazy, man. And I had a squeaky voice too. Squeaky, man. I was really scared because, you know, the type of music that they was listening to, like, doo doo doo. And
mm-hmm.
I went up there and got on lyrical shit. They just went crazy, man. I was like, this is a job for me, right? Here.
Okay, so since we just talked about that, you know what I'm going to do for you guys? I'm going to play one of his songs right now on live for everybody to listen to. Okay, he's on YouTube, Instagram, all that, but we're going to get a song live. Okay, I'm going to cut off my mic and just let y'all hear the music.
What can I say? Right. Let me explain this to you.
Check. You can find me on Pimpstagram, macking with a hundred shorties. Being spoken about over blunts and 40s. Look, Holmes, don't provoke me to anger. Choke that ass like Mad D, she did to Yanny Trainer. For her love of hip hop, my shit hot. I have the white chick screaming out my name like Kid Rock. His Majesty, King Hejaz SeeCash. A night vision sniper, let that heat blast. Yo, I'm lawless, flawless. Trade town, gorgeous. Pushing shit back like Mel Paradon, ballin'. I do my thing, bona fide, legal
hustler. Most of these so-called rappers are mad suspect. Chopping my pitchfork with sick thoughts. I'm not Rick Ross, but my style smooth like a Maybach. Lyrically, I stay strapped. I ice rappers like Richard Kalinsky, real MC from day one. I put that on my son. A lot of rappers drop jewels, but they actually slum. Got a distinctive voice that you can always remember. I'm legal hustle, first round draft pick. I rap sick. So I hope you ill. You better call the Vatican or rent a popo bill. I'm dope for real. Twice intense when I'm fighting, especially when I put my intentions in writing. I had money in a shoebox stash. Then further down the line, to I became D Jazz. Rappers oversaturated and become a deterrent. If you ask me, there are more rappers than germs.
The gangsters, cosmetic. My people from the hood stay on the grind. Your gangsters, cosmetic, cosmetic.
Okay, we're back. Now, y'all heard the full song. When I listened to it, I was like, this is some music that I would definitely want in an old school type of feel, gangster type of book that I would write, or a show I would want to write in the future. That's some type of music that I would want. I don't care what anybody says. That's the type of music that I would listen to, because I'm an alternative person and I'm different. Uh-huh. And that was some good music.
Appreciate that. Salute.
No problem. So, what made you write that? What was your inspiration with that song?
Which one was that?
That was Legal Hustle First Round Draft Pick.
Ooh, woo, that joint is a killer. Oh my gosh. That's just on some old lyrical shit right there. Like, that's more like a song like, don't even think about coming against me because I'm gonna bite your head off. I mean, like, that's a battle rap, straight up.
Mm-hmm.
Straight up, like, don't come for me. Don't even think about it. You know, like, I'm very competitive when it comes to it, but I'm, like I said before, I'm a lyricist. I can write about anything, you know? I can write about anything. Like, you know, like, I can write a song about you. You know what I mean?
Okay, so, if someone was to give you, like, say, a Jay-Z beat or a Nas beat, would you be able to come with it strong and write a song to it and just go in? That's what I want to know.
Absolutely. I mean, like, need that beat? Give me the beat. Beat is ill. I'll sit down. I'll write to it. It'll be a rap. That's it.
Mm.
I'll bring it full throttle like I like the full model. Easy. Let me tell you something, man. I'm the kid with the golden vocals with more written paragraphs than Barnes & Noble. I'm trying to tell you, I get it in. Anytime.
That's a lyricist. It really is. For you to come strong and be like, yes, that means something. Like, if you would have hesitated and be like, no, that's not my feel, I'd have been like, well, then what about this? Now you just said on spot, yes. So that makes me want to think, like, what other beats could he get on and just go and make it fire? You know what I'm saying? Yeah,
let me tell you something. When that Legal Hustle Volume 2 drops, it's going to be bananas. I believe Cormega's overseeing the whole project. That's a Cormega project. That's a Legal Hustle project. Right? He's the CEO of that project. I'm just featuring it. And we got my man Klepto. I think he's the executive producer. Klepto. That album is going to be fire. I mean, it's going to be incredible. So following that, you know, I'm planning on dropping an EP probably like late October. So be prepared. I'm cooking. Definitely.
And another thing, how did you get your name? How did you get your
artist name? My name's Let me go by the names. Like, you can call me Handsome He, Quincy Jones. I take that back. Quincy Pone, Jamie Middleton, Hejaz SeeCash. No, I'm kidding. And I hated my name, right? When I first started rapping, right?
Mm-hmm.
I was known as MC James BD, right? Then I went, you know, then I became MC James Jazzy, right?
Mm-hmm.
So my brother, he used to always call me Hejaz. I hated it. I was like, yo, when he used to call me Hejaz, I wanted to take his head off. And then when they told me what Hejaz meant, like he said, Hejaz, and it's a city in Mecca. I was like, I don't like it. Still don't like it. Don't call me that. So as time went by, it became one with me. I became Hejaz. I had to be Hejaz. Matilda, mm-hmm. I had to be Hejaz. So now I'm Hejaz. And I just threw on that SeeCash because I like to see money.
Mm-hmm.
So pretty much I'm Hejaz. Hejaz SeeCash. Yeah.
That's what's up. Now, I know you've had your ups and your downs in your career. What can you tell anyone who's trying to, you know, be an artist or a songwriter or actor? What can you give? What kind of advice can you give them?
Tell them haters for free, man. Like, if you got negative energy around you, man, just cut it off, man. Because you're going to have people that's going to down you, man. And they're gonna say, nah, you can't do that. And you can't do that. They're going to also have, you got people around you that just like to talk about other people's money. And like, JD is rich, the person's rich, whatever. Yo, get away from people, man, and just do your own thing, man. Keep striving, never give up, man. Never give up, man.
Mm-hmm.
You can't. But look, don't become obsessed with being a rapper. You have to prioritize and you know, set things up correctly. Like, you just can't be honest. Like, I would base my whole life around being a rapper. That, think bigger than that. Like, if you want to be a lawyer, be a lawyer. You know, you be a doctor, be a doctor. You know, I'm going to be a rapper. That's just kidding. Nah, B. Don't go out like that. I mean, pursue your dream, but don't become obsessed with it.
Mm-hmm.
Because it will drive you crazy. I know some people now, they start obsessed with being a rapper, man, and they're losing their mind. They just don't understand. They're like, yo, why this rapper got that? I'm better than that rapper. That rapper's whack, and I'm ill. I'm a better. It just drives them crazy. But, you know, do your thing, and take baby steps. Take baby steps, definitely. With moderation, definitely.
So that was a good point. That really was. That is very inspirational. Is there any point in your career where you felt like maybe this isn't for me, or maybe I won't be where I wanted to be or famous? Is there any point where you felt a little bit down and you had to, you know, get picked back up and like slap yourself, be like, listen, I'm gonna work as hard as I can to get where I need to be, where you are now? Is there any point you felt that way?
I believe there was, you know, and I just kept it moving, man. I was like I'll listen to myself and I'm like, yo, Hejaz, man, like, yo, you're doing it, you have a bigger purpose in life. Like, for me, it was never about having a name or being famous. Like, I just wanted to rap, and I wanted people to embrace my creativity, you know. So I didn't care about, like, you know, having my name in the spotlight and all of that. And I said, you know what, alright, man, I'm just gonna just take it one day at a time. But yeah, there was times that I just said, man, I felt like, you know, I'm not going to do this, and I'm going to fall back, and then I just bounce right back.
Mm-hmm.
I put my heart, because I'm a real lyricist. I'm an artist. I create art. An artist cannot stop. He can't. Like, I'm telling you, like, you can't. If you're a real artist, you just can't. Like, some people are like, I'm not rapping anymore. You're not a real artist, man. Because, yo, you would never give up. You would never give. My mother loves to draw. She can draw anything.
Me too. Right?
She's an artist, but she's not a professional artist, but it's something that she enjoys doing.
Mm-hmm.
Art. So, do what you do, make it happen, make it work by any means necessary. Yeah.
Yeah, and like what you just said, I'm an artist myself. You know, I have many talents that, you know, I always wanted to pursue in, and that's what I'm doing, you know? I built my own brand, my own business, and will continue to grow as I get older and I get more wise in what I'm doing. So, with that being said, we are at our last moments of this interview. Is there any shout outs you'd like to give?
Oh, no doubt. Let me give a few, man, because, I'm going to take it to the old school. You know, I give out a shout out back in the day. I want to send a shout out to War Child Sinister, probably one of the dopest MCs in Crown Heights, Brooklyn. I gotta get that brother a shout out because he deserves that. I mean, like, this kid never gets the recognition that he deserves. So I'm giving it to him right now, goddammit. Salute to War Child Sinister. My man, Culture, Baby Culture. I want to send a shout out to J180 Forever. You can follow him on Instagram. I want to send a shout out to my cousin Mackie. I want to send a shout out to DJ Larry Action. I want to send a shout out to Ken Lean, who's on Instagram. I am the B Ramsey. I want to definitely send a shout out to my man Klepto for the Legal Hustle Volume 2. And I want to send super shout out to my man Paul Mega for helping me out and helping Hejaz get on his feet. So salute to all y'all, man, and one, I love you all. Salute.
And that was that. Love you guys. Have a great night. I see y'all later.